For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. So we're here to bring you a good news. Actually, a lot of people are celebrating Christmas, and just a side note, Christmas is about Jesus Christ. So if you're celebrating Christmas and you're not celebrating it because of the person of Jesus Christ, that's actually being disrespectful. It's like going to someone else's birthday party and just having fun, drinking your own drink, going into the bedroom and the bathroom and doing whatever and disrespecting the person's house. That's what it is like if you're celebrating Christmas and you don't actually worship Jesus Christ, who is the reason for the season. It's actually a celebration of the birth of Jesus Christ to save us from our sins. Right, today I'm going to talk about something. I know people want to have good news, you know, joyful news and all that. But what I'm going to say today is, how can fear be your best friend? How can fear be your best friend? So someone might be thinking, what is he talking about? You know, so if I use an analogy, if you're on a cliff and you're about to fall off and the sand is just going off and you're feeling like you're scared, you know, that fear itself is not a good feeling. It's not a good feeling. But if you think about it properly, that fear at that point is your best friend. Why is it your best friend? Because that fear is telling you to move back from the cliff. Move back from the cliff because you're in danger. And the Bible says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Woo! The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. When you have the fear of God, you're wise, you know what to do. Because wisdom is knowing what to do and doing it. So think about it, are you wise? Are you wise? You know, the Bible says, through the fear of God, men depart from iniquity. Men depart from their sins. Why do I need to depart from my sins? Because the Bible says, it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. If God judges you, who's going to save you? So let the fear of the Lord start working in your heart.
To glory start thinking, to God.
All the sins I've committed against the holy God, if he judges me, how am I going to fare? It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the Almighty God. Start thinking about it. It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. Now, this is what the Bible says. Fear not that person who can kill your body. Who can kill your body.
Yes.
And after that, he cannot do anything else.
Yeah.
That's like mankind can do anything to you.
Yeah.
They can hurt you. Even the devil can afflict you, whatever. But the Bible says, fear him who can kill your body and still throw you into hell.
Mm.
And who is that? That is God. God can, he owns everything, and he can hurt your body and still throw you to hell. The Bible says, fear him. Don't fear man, fear him. The Bible says, appointed unto man once to die, and after that comes the judgment. Then when the judgment of God comes, what's going to happen? Someone might think to himself, what have I done actually to want God to judge me? What have I done for me to be fearful of the Almighty God? The Bible says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Hallelujah.
We have sinned, broken God's rules.
Mm.
And the Bible says one day he's going to judge us in righteousness.
Yes.
That's why it says it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the Almighty God.
So good.
What do we need to do? The Bible says all men everywhere are commanded to repent and believe in the gospel. And what is the gospel? That Jesus, the reason for this Christmas season, died on the cross so that your sins will be forgiven and you will be reconciled back to the God who made you.
Hallelujah.
Jesus, when he died on the cross, he said, it is finished. And what does that mean? Your sins have been paid for.
Woo!
I said that last week. Your sins have been paid for. All you need to do is to repent of your sins and accept the payment for your sins, the sacrifice for your sins. So when you appear before God on the judgment day or when you die, the Bible says that God is going to see the righteousness of Christ and yeah. He's not going to see your sins.
Yes.
Because your sins have been paid for.
Yes.
Remember this, it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the Almighty God. So everyone hearing my voice, please think about this. Think about this. When God judges you for your sins, what's going to happen to you? It's a fearful thing to fall into the Almighty God. A lot of people have this idea of this celestial being that is just like a butler to you, giving you everything. He's just a nice guy. You know, God is not all loving. I'm going to say it again. God is not all loving. God is also just.
Yes.
He's loving, but he's also just. He's loving, but he's also just. So don't just, you know, ignore the justice part of God and just think, oh, God is nice. He's going to look after me. I'm going to be with him in heaven. I said to someone over there, I said to him, if you want to go to heaven, which is God's own house, you need to play by his rules.
Woo!
You can't just come into God's own house by your own self, however you want.
So you
know,
knock
about and do whatever and just turn up and say, God, I'm going to come into your house. No.
There's glory rules. To God.
God is a God of rules.
Woo!
God is a God of rules. He's a God of order. And if you have to come into his house, you have to follow his rules. And what's his rule? You have to repent of your sins. I have sinned. You have sinned. You've broken God's rules. You have to repent of them. Because the sins you commit, you know, when you offend other people, it's not just about them. It's also about the God who made you, who made these rules, and you've broken them. And one day, God is going to judge you. I've lied, I've stolen, I've done all these things. You've done that as well. But the only difference between a lot of people walking around and me, I'm not better than them. I am just better off because my sins have been paid for.
I've accepted
the payment of Christ on the cross for my sins.
Hallelujah.
My sins are washed. The sins I committed yesterday, today, even tomorrow, it's all forgiven. Not because of what I've done, but because of the sacrifice of Christ.
Hallelujah.
On the cross. All you need to do, wherever you are, is to repent. Say to God, I'm sorry for my sins. Repent from your sins. Don't be a hypocrite and say, oh, I just told, you know, a little lie, white lies here and there. No. A sin is a sin. There's no size. A sin is a sin because it's a sin against a holy, eternal God.
Yes.
Just repent of your sins and say to God, I'm sorry. Accept the payment of Christ. Say, put your trust in Christ because you don't have any righteousness of your own to go to heaven. Because the Bible says our righteousness is like a filthy rag before God. It's like a filthy rag. It's nothing. Only Christ, the sinless human, God's human that died on the cross, is the only person can set you free from sin.
So
you can cleanse you from all unrighteousness. The Bible says when you repent, God promises to forgive all your sins like the east is to the west. He's not going to remember them anymore. And you become a child of God, and that's the only way you can go to God's place. Only God's children can go to heaven, which is God's house.
Wow.
So that's the end of my message. So what I'm saying today is, in conclusion, let the fear of God start working in your heart.
Amen.
Because it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the Almighty God. Let the fear of God, you know, start working in your heart. Start thinking about it. Because the Bible says, remember I said that, you know, through the fear of God, men will depart from their sins.
Mm.
When you start thinking of God as the Almighty God and not play down your sins. Don't play down your sins to say, I'm just telling porkies, I'm just telling white lies. A sin is a sin in the sight of the Almighty God. So please repent of your sins and accept the payment of Christ for your sins and you will be saved.
Hallelujah.
God bless you for listening. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Glory to God.